Another thing that I'd like to show you about St. Meinrad is the living accommodations we have here. Tom Jelinek has agreed for us to come into his room and show us around. But first, Robert Harris, hey, you look like you're busy.
Yes.
Can I ask you a few questions?
Sure.
Now, I know you came from a state school out west. Mm-hmm. Could you tell the audience, and me too, a little bit about the difference between the people you met there and here?
Well, I think the big difference is that at my state school, I was one of 45,000 people, whereas here, it's like a big fraternity. You have 100 brothers that are your good friends, that you party with, that care about you, and even that you fight with, just like a big family.
Yeah, I know. So I've met some really good friends here.
Yeah, I've met many friends I'll have for the rest of my life.
Rob, hey, thanks for talking with me. You can get back
care.
To work.
See ya.
Let's go in and talk to Tom now. He usually has something good to talk about.
The other day.
Tom, Mario, what's
hey,
up? I didn't
hey,
expect
Tom,
to see you here.
Going?
Are you just visiting? I'm not interrupting anything.
Oh, no.
I told you I was going to come by and ask you a few questions about the living accommodations.
That's cool.
Mario, as long as you're here, can you answer me a few questions about what you think about the rooms here?
Well, the rooms are very nice. You know, you have your own studies. Then you have a dorm room here that you share with somebody as freshman and sophomore. Junior and senior year, you get your own room. And you share a lounge with the guys next door and, you know, build some atmosphere. You want to have a party, you can have it outside. Then you want some private time, just close your door and, you know, this room is your little house.
Right. It can be really peaceful. I mean, you can get away from noises and stuff.
Now, I know they... The rooms, they come furnished, but what about this thing? They didn't have this.
You don't
here,
like right? The couch? The couch is a beauty, Tom.
Now, exactly, how much did you pay for this?
It's like $3.95 at the bargain basement. It's kind of exciting. I like the floral.
Yeah, it goes with the decor really well here.
Sure.
But seriously, folks, I wanted to tell you a little about the rooms because it makes it special here. But the thing is that the rooms here are just like the people.
Oh, geez, Tom.
They're very unique and both individual. Get out of here, man. You gotta come and see it for yourself.
Intramural sports are a big part of life here at St. Meinrad. This is the floor hockey championship game going on right now, and we'll just watch for a little bit. Tell us a little bit about your experience with St. Meinrad sports in general.
Sports in general?
Mm-hmm.
Well, for me, that's a lot of stuff. I play soccer in the fall, basketball in the wintertime. Then I do intramural hockey right now in the spring. But it's all a lot of fun. Everybody gets into it. It's a really cool thing around here.
Just a way to kind of, you know, ease off your anxieties and kind of let go every once in a while.
Yeah, and have a lot of fun with the guys here. It's cool.
All right, thanks. See you around, bud. Tom and I are hanging out down here at the end table with some of our friends after a hard day's work in classes.
Now, I'd like to ask you guys a few questions just about what do you like about St. Meinrad. John, Jim, can you tell me something?
I like it. It's fun, exciting, and it's also challenging.
Yeah, Jim.
It's a great spiritual formation program and a lot of great people.
Yeah, it's the people that makes it. But what do you do around here? Harlan?
Well, usually every night I go down to the gym, work out. Usually there's four hockey games or volleyball games. Down the gym, and there's also a library up here, so we can get movies for free and watch them.
For whatever reason, students come to St. Meinrad, whether it be the academics, the spiritual formation, or the tradition.
Or just plain fun.
Yeah, everybody enjoys it, and they're happy to be here. Speaking of tradition, Tom.
What?
Hey there, Thomas. Happy birthday.
Oh, Father Karen. I didn't think you'd remember.
Oh, happy birthday.
Thanks, guys.
You better go take care of tradition so we can wrap it up here, bud. There's some things you can't see until you come and see.